I first got started with robotics when I saw like the poster about the team. So then I came here and it looked like it was fun, so I stayed.
Well, as a kid, I always played with Erector sets, and these parts are pretty similar to Erector sets as far as putting them together. But when it comes to building the robot, it's a lot of trial and error. You build something, it doesn't work, you tweak it a bit, see what works and doesn't, and then try to build it again.
Before Vex Robotics, I mostly used Lego Mindstorms, and I was really good at that, so I already knew like some of the same programming styles and building styles.
Our robot fell apart at the competition. The base was way too heavy, so we're going to have different parts that are lighter.
To improve their chances at qualifying for the world competition, the robotics team took their old robot apart to make a new and improved version.
So, the goal with this machine is to use the scoring system. So, what we're going to do to get points is actually take this ball, it's going to go in here,
and if I turn this on, it'll take a second for it to actually
boot up and everything. But this ball would go in here, and we'll be able to lift it and move it around and get it into the goal zone. So if this motor spins in, you can see this ball, we would move forward and pick this up like that. And then we can have this lift. That's good. And we'll move it down to here so we can actually see what's going on. And then if we reverse the direction, we can actually spit that out. And in theory, that would go into the goal zone where we want it. The way the scoring system works, there's a lot of different methods you can use to get points. There are three main zones. There's the back zone, middle zone, and end zone. And I'm not as clear on this as some of the other guys are, but the main way to get points that we're going to be using is picking up these balls, getting them in here, and then dropping it into one of the canisters, which is about 2 feet high. In order to prepare for the next competition, we've been doing a lot of training using this machine here. We want to make sure that we are well prepared and ready to win the competition.
Over the next few days, the Framingham Robotics team spent the next few days practicing their driving skills to be ready for the New England Championships. They practiced ways to score points by taking large spheres into certain zones and scoring smaller spheres into elevated canisters. After a week of putting finishing touches on their robot, the robotics team went to Herbert Auditorium to compete in the New England Championships.
And in blue, all this is Bill Rickamask in his T5313B, the RoboRobo. Last but not least, from Framingham, Massachusetts, T9421. All right. Both alliances are ready. Let's rock and roll here in Flea. Blue, are you guys ready? A-OK. All right, let's rock and roll here in 3, 2, 1, go.
Yep. All right, so right now we're in the autonomous mode. So that's 15 seconds, and nobody's controlling the robot. It's just programmed to do what it's doing, and you can earn extra points by winning the autonomous round.
The Framingham Robotics team were able to achieve a high ranking early in the tournament. This is especially thanks to their programming skills, which earned them bonus points in the beginning of each match.
We'll be right back.
So this time we did way better than, and we came in 38th place for the competition out of 75. But at the beginning, we were in second place after winning twice in a row. After that, after the end of the first day, we were in 28th place. And then at the end of the day, today, we lost twice in a row. So now we're going to do the skills challenge for programming.
As far as programming skills, we came in 6th place with a score of 21. The winning score was 39. And had we gotten, I think, 4 more points, we would have been in the top 3. But as far as good news, we qualified for the World Championships as a result of us winning the programming skills competition in a previous scrimmage and then getting a high score in the next 2. So we upheld a high enough score to qualify us for Worlds. And right now, we're thinking about going and starting to prepare for it.
Now that the robotics team has qualified for the World Championships, they need to fundraise in order to get to California.